Remnants of Hurricane Sandy continue to assault part of the Northeast with wind, rain, and snow.
As this unusual storm weakens, there's been more talk of global warming. Our Natalie Stoll is in the Weather Center and takes a look at Sandy and climate change.
Hurricane Sandy's winds stretched from Maine to North Carolina, covering nearly 1,000 miles. The size and scope of this storm have some people making a connection to climate change. We received several emails and decided to go in depth. Not just inches, but around a foot of rain in New Jersey, where Sandy made landfall as a Category 1 hurricane. Life-threatening flooding and even wind-driven snow. Sandy was dubbed a superstorm and even Frankenstorm for its unusual formation. Dr. Carrie Cook, a climate scientist and professor at the University of Texas, calls it a hybrid.
It was drawing energy from the warm tropical Atlantic, but it was also drawing energy from those strong temperature gradients associated with the jet stream and the cold front.
For some, it was just another weather event.
I really think it's just another hurricane. I mean, the East Coast gets hurricanes, so I really don't think it has anything to do with climate change at all.
Others say it's a sign of something more.
I think most climate scientists think that not necessarily the frequency of hurricanes, but that they are getting bigger.
And while there's no direct connection,
it is exactly the kind of thing we expect to happen more under global warming. With a warmer ocean, in fact, the western Atlantic was several degrees warmer than normal ahead of Sandy, which probably helped to feed energy into Sandy and make the storm stronger and bigger.
Then factor in the cold front Sandy merged with.
This year was the record low amounts of sea ice in the Arctic, and that's associated with the setting up of a high, what we call a blocking high over the North Atlantic, and that kind of funneled the cold air south in to meet with Sandy, and it also caused Sandy to turn inland for it to go west to the northwest the way it did.
Dr. Cook says expect months of analysis on the connection between Sandy and global warming.
I've been working on this field for a number of decades, and it's certainly something we've understood for a long time, and we think we're seeing it happening now in many ways.
Natalie Stoll, KXAN News.
A recent survey from the Yale Project on Climate Communication found nearly three-quarters of Americans believe global warming is affecting weather in the U.S. They released more results in September.